And in business, the Nigerian data protection regulations issued by the National Information Technology Development Agency introduced major compliance obligations on data controllers, for which I mean organizations that collect, process and store personal data. Here to speak with me on this is Yetunde Filani. She is the Manager, Tax Advisory and Regulatory Services Unit at Andersen Tax. Thank you so much for joining me in the studio.
Thank you for having me. Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's just speak regarding the data protection law. What exactly prompted the government to really go hard on this?
Okay. Globally, the issue of data protection has been a burning issue. Mm-hmm. You know, we've seen companies like Facebook have to pay huge regulatory fines.
Yeah, there was a conversation with Analytica. Yes,
yes, mm-hmm. For breach of privacy. And the European Union actually issued its own regulation, the General Data Protection Regulation, the GDPR, in mm-hmm. 2016, which became effective in 2018. And NITA, that's the agency in charge of information technology, also saw the need for Nigeria to also follow suit and issued its own regulation, which is modeled after the GDPR. Mm-hmm. And basically, the regulation tries to ensure that personal data of Nigerians and foreigners living in Nigeria are protected, and Nigerian businesses are also able to compete, you know, globally with other organizations.
Because I understand that once people are confident enough that their data is protected, then they can, you know, freely share it. But what has been the success stories, if we've had any so far?
Well, so far, the regulation was issued January 2019, so this year, and it places some compliance obligations on organizations in Nigeria. First of all, there's a need to publish your privacy notice, so it's not business as usual. You cannot just collect personal data without letting the data subjects know the purpose for which you're collecting the data and what you're going to use the personal data for. And beyond that, there's also an obligation to carry out a mandatory self-audit on your data practices. When doing so, you're supposed to work with organizations that need that as license. These organizations are called data protection compliance organizations. Okay. And Andersen Tax is one of such organizations.
Okay. So when are we really protected when we take a look at these things? Because sometimes you get emails from, you know, companies that, although you know that you probably need their services, but you did not either apply to get emails from them. How exactly do you get our emails if all of these regulations are put in place and expectations are that organizations are adhering to the regulations?
Yeah, absolutely correct. So this is what this regulation is trying to curb. It's not business as usual where you just get random emails of people asking you to buy land or buy this. Where did they get that information from? Now, what the regulation is trying to say is that anybody that collects personal data, and personal data is as simple as your name, your phone number, your date of birth, your email address, those are all personal data, must, you know, either it must inform you of the purpose for collecting that information and cannot transfer that information anywhere else without your consent. So the issue with data privacy is not the collection or using the information, it's the fact that do you even have consent, you know, to deal with the personal data in the way that you have done.
Oh, well, I should say that I don't think everything is being sorted out, but a lot of work still needs to be done, right? But then what are the fines or what are the consequences of not adhering to this particular regulation?
Well, the consequences are huge. So under the regulation, a company could be fined as high as 2% of its annual gross revenue. And note, it's gross revenue, not profit, you know, for the preceding year, for any breach of personal data. So what is important for organizations to take note of is that there's a need for you to do an assessment of your practices. Need that actually, you know, there was a deadline for that. That should have been done by the 25th of July. They gave a 3-month extension, which elapsed on the 25th of October. Okay. You know, and a lot of organizations are actually taking steps towards complying with that obligation. But it's not too late, you know, to reach out to a DPCO and engage them, conduct your mandatory audits, and file your returns with NIDA. And as we always say, it's actually best to comply. It's cheaper to comply than to deal
and
with
the consequences. Yes. Thank you so much for joining me in the studio.
Thank you so
time
much.
Is all we can have. Thank you so
all
much.
All right. Thank you so much.
And that's all we can have on Business News at this hour. Still ahead on Plus TV African News is our roundup on entertainment and sports. We'll be back in a moment.